Hi, I'm Jen. Welcome. Today we're talking about the data analytics skills that you won't learn in college. There are a few of them, but there's one key one that every hiring manager wishes that you had, and in many cases, if you're just getting out of college, you may not have. I've spent over 15 years working in analytics and hiring analysts, so I know exactly where the challenges are when you're just getting out of school and getting into an analytics or data science field. And I also know the frustration and challenges that hiring managers are facing, which you probably feel when you're a candidate and aren't getting calls back or aren't getting that second interview. The number one skill that analysts right out of school tend to be lacking is how to apply all of those technical skills that you just learned to real-world problems. You're probably amazing at analyzing research questions. Life is ambiguous, though. There is so much that's not defined and not known when we're doing analysis in business settings. And this is where a lot of people get hung up. They don't have all of the information they need to perform the analysis, and they tend to freeze up, or they go searching for all of the answers so that they can do this textbook analysis. And that's just not reality. It's good to look for answers and question things, but there are often going to be times where you're going to be analyzing information and you don't have all of the facts. That's part of your job, is to explain things that we don't understand. The second closely related skill that you won't learn in college is how to make information meaningful to people. You know, as an analyst, that the data is meaningful. I know, as a manager that used to be an analyst, that the data is meaningful. But most people honestly don't give a crap what your data says if you don't give it context and meaning. You have to tell people why they should care about the data that you analyzed or the results that you got. All the statistical knowledge or programming knowledge or algorithms that you learn to create are completely useless if you can't explain them and give meaning to them to people that aren't data-centered people. They're also completely meaningless if you can't use them to solve real-world problems. You can have a high education level, you could have a PhD, and still not actually know how to apply those skills. Sure, you may be extremely book smart, but businesses aren't just looking for book smart. They're looking for people that can take what they've learned and apply it to real world situations and business problems and challenges to be able to make the business run better. This is where the third skill comes in, and that's understanding business from a business lens. You can perform analysis even without knowing much about the subject. And for a lot of people, we do this naturally in our day-to-day lives. If you're an analyst, you're probably analytically thinking through most of the things in your life. You may have Excel spreadsheets for stuff nobody else would. The better you understand a topic, and in this case, it's business and what business is trying to accomplish, and even so far as the types of questions that the business needs to answer, even if they're not asking the right questions, a lot of times what people ask for when they ask for analysis is what they think the solution or the path to their end answer is. It's not really asking what they want to know at the end. So getting used to challenging people, sorting out good questions and good analysis processes is so key. Use your intellectual capabilities to analyze the data and then focus immensely on the communication. 99%+ of people out there are not that familiar with data analysis. Even people that really use some of the same processes, like doctors, oftentimes aren't that familiar with what data analysis is. So break it down, put context to it, put it in plain language. That's the entire value to me of a data analyst. This is where people will have an involvement for many years to come in analytics. A computer can run an algorithm or do machine learning or AI data analysis work, but a computer can't often give context and put things into plain language. The reason that you're hired as a data analyst or a data scientist is because you bring this value that computers can't, at least not yet. And that's really giving context and meaning to all of this data that's analyzed. You're really hired to help solve business problems and put a puzzle together of the different issues that come up and be able to explain it and give context and meaning to everyone else. Just because these aren't skills that you'll learn in college doesn't mean that you can't learn them while you're in college. You will be a really powerful, strong candidate if you learn how to do real-world application of problems and then can reflect that on your resume. You could do this by taking problems that have already been solved, setting aside the answer, and doing the entire process start to finish. Or take something in your personal life that you find interesting and research it. It doesn't have to be a hardcore centered around financial data or production data or things that we typically think of when we think of data analysis. It could be something like weather phenomenon or sports statistics or really anything, as long as you can show how you got from the start to the end and address a practical problem where you didn't have all of the data and all of the knowledge available to you. Those are my top three skills that you won't learn as a data analyst in college, but will make you a super powerful candidate if you do learn them. What questions do you have about them? Let me know in the comments. I'd be happy to talk with you about it. For more insights on data analysts and data science careers, subscribe to the channel and turn on notifications. I'm here every Thursday talking about all things related to analytics. I hope to see you back.